Hello friends, in the last two videos, we looked at how a new process is created using fork and managed using exec, wait and exit functions. Also in the last video, I gave an example through code to understand these functions. Let's now look at some more examples to understand these functions. So before we go and solve these problems, let's revise some important concepts about fork and C programming, which would be very helpful in solving these problems. Let's now walk through some important points before solving the problems. So the first important point is two processes. So when a process is created using fork, two processes returns from the fork, which are almost identical. So there are some differences between the parent and the child process that I already have discussed in my previous videos. So you can watch those videos to understand those differences. So if you let's see this through a diagram. So we have the code PID equal to fork. So here two different processes will be returned. It's not that two different processes will be created. Only one new process will be created, that will be the child. Parent is already there, which is running. And the difference between these two processes will be that the PID will be greater than 0 for the parent process. So this will be the PID of the child. And for the child, the PID will be 0. And these two processes will now run differently. So the difference is that if you just print the PID in this, it will be greater than 0. In the child, it will be 0. Another important point is once the fork returns, fork call returns with some value, that is PID here. After that, both the parent and the child start the execution from the next line itself. So both the parent and child will start execution from printf hello world. So this is very important in knowing where the execution starts for both the parent and the child after the fork returns. But one important question, but do they start executing at the same time? At the same time means, let's say the time after which fork returned is, let's say, some 7:40. So will child and parent execute this print of hello world at the same time? So the answer is no. So if you watch my previous videos, I have talked about process scheduling, so that which is a very complex process. So in that, what happens, these two processes will be there, P1 and P2. So it may happen that if, let's say, if you have two processes, it may happen that they both can execute at the same time. But this rarely happens, since the algorithms which is used by the process scheduling is very complex. So in most cases, they will run at some different time. That depends on the scheduler, process scheduler. Let's now again visit C programming and see some important properties of and or operator, which is very useful when we look at examples of for in which if is involved. So if x and y, right? So this, let's say the x value is 0. So if the value of x is 0, the compiler even won't check the value of y. So it won't go after this. So it won't execute this. If there are some instructions related to this, it won't be executed at all. You only look at x, okay, its value is 0. That means that in any case, this is going to be false. I mean, if the y is 1 or 0, right? It can't go inside this if statement. So it won't look at y. But let's check another case. If x is 1, we have to look at y, since we don't know the value of y. Let's say if y is 0, so we cannot go inside the if statement. And if y is 1, we can go inside the if statement. Same for or. So if x value is 1, we do not need to look at the value of y, since it will always be true. If y is 0 or y is 1. But if the value of x is 0, So we have to look at the value of y. In case the y is 1, we can go inside the if. If it is a 0, we cannot go. So this is as a basics of C programming. Another important thing I wanted to discuss was, so if x at y and some code here, so this can also be, this is almost equivalent to writing if x then if y inside. So this is same as this statement, right? So if x, right, if x is 1, right, so you can go inside, but if x is 0, you cannot go inside, right? So in this case, if x becomes 0, right, there is no use to check y, right? You can just start executing, compiler can start executing from here. In this case, simply look for x or y. So if x is, let's say, 0 here, right, then also we need to check for y, right? Because it can be like, if y is 1, then we can execute the if code. But if x becomes 1, yeah, we can also execute x code. So in both the cases we can execute, but in this case only when x is 1 there is some chance to execute the code. Let's now look at the first example and try to solve this and answer 5 questions here. So we have 3 for statements, 1, 2, and 3, and then we have 2 printf statements, and we need to answer question based on this code. So for the first question is, so first you should remember all the important points that I have discussed before that will be very useful in solving this type of problems. Okay, now look at the first question. So the first question is total number of process created. So we should clearly read the question, total number of process created, right? And the second question, total number of child process created, right? So there is difference between these two, right? We'll look into it. So first solve the first question, total number of process created. So I will write this, let's say, it's like my naming convention. I will write this as F1, first fork. This as F2, and this as F3. And I will be using this in my diagrams. So initially what will happen, there will be a process. P will be the parent process, right? Which will, this is a code. Is our code, and the execution would have already been here before coming here, and one process that is the parent process will be executing this, right? Now it sees this first fork, this so what will happen, two process will be created, not created, so two process will now return. So one will be F1, another will also be F1, right? But the difference will be, this will return with the code, and sorry, the status code here, status code here will be 1, here it will be 0. So return code, not status code, right? Now this f, both this process, this is the parent and this is the child, both will start execution from the next line, so which is this line, from the f2, right? So now f1 will again spawn F2, and this will also be F2. Again, the return code here will be 1, will be 0 here. So this, the child of this, the parent, this will also execute the same code, giving birth to one more child. And this also will be 1, 0, right? Now, okay, we will look at printf next. First let's count run our process. Now the execution will come here. This will execute it by like all the process which are currently there. There are 1, 2, 3, 4 process before this third fork call. So each of this will now execute this fork. So again you will have here F3. Return code will be different for both the process. So we will be using this diagram in, so this type of diagrams in all our examples. So we will be writing the naming all the fork as F1, F2, F3, and then we'll use those in our diagram. So it depends on you how you want to name this. You can name these as C1, C2, C3, C4, but for me, I want to see this is F2, right? So where is the control now? It's there, right? So when I go back to this diagram, I know that at which point of code I am there. So how, so the total number of process created is 2, 4, 6, 8, right? This is the total number of process created. The next is total number of child process created. So we already know that one process will be the parent process. So this will be this process. This last one, this will be P here, right? So this is parent, right? Again, 1, 1, 1. So this will be the parent process only. And then you will have this many childs. That is 7 childs. So total number of childs will always be how many processes you have minus 1. So that will be total number of child, because 1 will be always be the parent process. The next question is number of times hello and world is printed. So this this is the print of hello, right? Okay, let's first clean this. So this is the print of right hello. So how many times this will be printed? So this will be printed by how many process we have till here, right? The first two fork, right? So if you look at the first two fork, how many processes were there? You see right here, you had 4 processes, right? And all these 4 processes are going to execute this line, right? So total number of hello, if you see, will be, so count of hello will be 4, right? And the count of world will be, so after, so now this will be printed by all the process which has been created till here, right? With these 3 fork statements, right? So F1, F2, F3, so that will be the this is all, right? So that will be the answer will be 8. So all the leaf nodes which we have, right? These are all the processes which we get after 3 fork statements. Let's now move to the fourth question. Order in which they are printed. So first answer, we will answer a question. If somebody is asking, print the output of this program. So will there be an specific output like hello world? So will there be, only one output for this, or will there be multiple outputs for this? Multiple output in the sense that if you run one time, you get some output, let's call it 1. Next time you run, it gives some output 2, 3. And these all may be same or may be different. We don't know about it. So what will be the answer? Are you going to get the same output every time or different output every time? So if you see the modern operating systems or the modern process schedulers, the algorithms they use are very complex in nature. So we cannot predict which process is going to get the CPU next. So the answer here will be, it of course depends on the processor. So we can rewrite the process in such a way that there will be only one output. But if you see the modern operating system, the answer will be it will be different output if you run it at the code at different times. So no particular output will be there. So the output can vary whenever you run the program. It will be a combination of this hello and world, but the order in which hello and world will be there will be different each time you run. Let's now look at the last question. Generalize this for n for calls. So we have fork this n times. And you have to answer the first two questions. You generalize this for first two. Total number of process created, total number of child process created. So if you look into this tree diagram, so this tree is called a binary tree, since all the nodes, if you see, have two children here. So they can have a max of two children. So it's a binary tree. And if you observe the last level, right? This level, right? All the leaf nodes, if you see, are at the same level. So this type of tree where all the, sorry, there are two conditions. So this is called a perfect binary tree. First is like all the internal nodes should have two children. Second condition is all leaf nodes. So leaf nodes are the nodes at the bottom which do not have any children. All leaf nodes should be at same level. So if you observe this tree, right, all these are leaf nodes and these are at the same level, right? So don't get confused by this diagram where I have drawn this bigger arrow. So these all are the same level. And this is the, so the height of this tree is, the tree is 3. So this is also the number of for calls we have, 3 for calls. So the formula is total processes equal to 2 power n. And total process 2 power n minus 1. So 1 is subtracted because of the parent. So how this formula came actually, I'm not going to give the proof of this formula, but there is a property of perfect binary tree. A total number of leaf nodes of a perfect binary tree is 2 power n, where n is the height of the tree. I will attach the link to the proof in the description. You can read it if you want to. So that's all for this video. In the next video, we are going to look at fork, using fork. Have a look at the code which involves fork, if statement, and or logical operators. We will look at the code which has a combination of this and try to solve some problems. Thank you.